Sunday morning we get up and everybody tells us that the Rebbe is coming to camp. Everybody got a special green yarmulke. The Rebbe came in his beige Cadillac and we were standing there lined up. That was one of the reasons officially why the Rebbe actually came to camp. Gan Yisrael is called Yisrael, and Yisrael Baal Shem Tov, as the Rebbe actually mentioned it. We stood by our beds, and when the Rebbe walked into my room, I think he smiled. And then I remember the old lady, we had a nurse, Mrs. Krauss, went with her whole white pagodim, and she went over to the Rebbe gave her a very nice brocha. Moshe Lazar was head counselor there. I think Avraham Shem Tov was standing next to him. And Macharekov was walking together. And everybody was very excited, running after the Rebbe. Pictures were being taken. Then we went down to the pool, the older lake. We had an artificial, beautiful artificial lake that we walked all the way down. The Rebbe asked about the Eruv, if I'm not mistaken. He asked about a basketball court, and he asked about a handball court. And then the Rebbe said, tennis, if I remember correctly. The Rebbe said, no, don't stop when he's talking. Walks very quickly and very briskly. You can see the Rebbe took in everything very clearly. We went to the Fabrengen in the main hall, which was used as a shul. Since at every Fabrengen the Rebbe wore a Zayden Sutuk, he went into the room next door and changed into his Shabbos Dikabeget. A big oilam came from all over the Catskills. Campers were in the middle and on the side of the lights and the buffer and all of us squeezed. My Yiddish wasn't too bad, so I understood a little bit. Rabbi gave out Keshel Brocha, then we got a bencher. It was a very, very excitable, especially for me. I had never seen such a thing and never experienced it. And it made a tremendous impact on everybody who was there.